One day, God came to me and told me, "My dear, I'm giving you a very special power nobody has ever got or will ever get. I stood still, silent and shocked, not able to believe God was standing near me. I pinched myself. God started laughing. "Yes, my dear, it's me only. Now listen carefully. There are three main seasons in India: summer, winter, and monsoon. And the one you select will be out forever very, very soon. Nobody will be able to experience it again. Think very carefully and reply to me in 3 days. And don't misuse the power given. Thank you," is all I could say, and he vanished. I was on cloud 9. It was just like I'm flying. I quickly grabbed a pen and a paper and went and sat under a tree to write peacefully the pros and cons of each season. Summer, I thought, is too hot to bear. The AC is always on and the electricity bill comes too high. It should go. Then I realized, no, it cannot go, because if it goes with it, my favorite mangoes will go away too. And yes, it is the favorite time of children. She will agree with me. It's the vacation time. I cannot steal the joy from the children. I moved on to next. The monsoon. Nobody likes waterlogging, dirt, the chikungunya, malaria, dengue, swine flu cases are on the rise. And one more thing. Drying clothes is also a very difficult task. Then I thought, let me write the good points of monsoon. Everybody loves tea with fritters, that is chai, with samosas, pakoras, bhajiyas. And who can forget the beautiful golden corn? And this is the time farmers wait for the whole year. If it rains, we get grains. So monsoon also cannot. I finalize. God will come and tell him winter has to go. Because people die on roads because of the severely cold, harsh winds. Yes. I cannot make a mistake. Because if I make a mistake, it will bring in a youth quake. So I had to look at the pros of winter also before my decision. It is the time when you get vegetables at a cheaper price, fresh ones. And yes, who doesn't like outdoor games? I now got scared. Didn't know what to do. As for me, all seasons were important. It was difficult to live without any. I was not able to take a decision. I thought, I'll take help. I'll take help from people who are mostly outdoors during all the three seasons. I could think of two: farmers and the traffic policeman. I chose the latter as it was easy to contact them. I went, "Sir, can you please tell me which is the season you least like and why?" His expression was as if I have asked him something related to the Pythagoras theorem. He replied, "Madam, I don't like any season. During summer, the sun. During monsoon, the water. And during winter, the winds torture me. Madam, please go." Now this responsibility was making me sick and nervous. I was back to square one. Just then God came and said, "Don't worry, I release you of your responsibility. Now do one thing. Place of seasons, put people you hate or dislike for any reason. See wisely, you will find some good in them too. They do have a heart with feelings within." Saying this, God vanished. And so did my dream. Yes, it was a dream which taught me a very valuable lesson that learn to forgive and forget. Hatred affects you only, that too badly, wasting your time and energy. The person whom you hate might not be affected at all. He is enjoying himself. You also enjoy yourself. Love and be loved in return. Their lives are good in everyone. Embrace the positive. Ignore the negative. Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam once said that, never hate your haters. They are the ones who think you are better than them. You hate wickedness in others. Why do you forget? There lies a bad side in you too. Is it easy for us to work or do things according to someone else's comfort and will? Not always. So why do we expect others to work or do things according to our comfort and will? Accept everything and everyone as they are, like you have accepted the seasons. And trust me, you will be the happiest person.